In a dream, you were sitting there waiting by the door for me. And I got the opportunity. Experience once again. How it could be.
So now I get to build the body width. You can base off the belly button to see how much this side of the torso and how much that side of the torso. And lower, you can kind of feel the rib cage if you want. Now I got my two-dimensional, like I said, focusing on one-dimensional, straight line, angle, and C-curve, and then focus on the two-dimensional, take those, and then one straight line, angle, whatever. Once you close that up, that turns into a 2D shape. You use that shape to compare the shape next to it, compare size next to it, compare next to that. So that's how we kind of get a proportion. Also, you need the negative space and the positive space too, okay?
He doesn't even have to try. Do you ever ask yourself how it could have maybe been?
Here's my just in my arm, right? Here's the tube, here's the, my top point, here's my side point. I know my core shadow has to be right above or right in the corner. And look at the trapezius. Okay, right at that corner. Look at this tendon of trapezius. It sits right at that corner, which is perfect for us to explain where the corner of the arm. The shadows has a tendency they all kind of combine to one big shape, you know. So you get this one shape of shadow from the head to the feet, which is a good thing for us. It helps to tie all the parts together too. Okay, so you don't end up making a shadow here, make a shadow there, making a shadow here, make a shadow. They start looking like a pattern. You want to keep them. You want to tie them up. Okay. See how the shadow from this and it casts over onto the hips. Every core shadow ends to a cast shadow. Keep in mind, every core shadow ends to a cast shadow. Every soft edge ends to a hard edge. Okay, every soft edge ends to the hard edge. Every soft edge ends to the hard edge. Okay. just give a nice solid lay-in, solid shape of the shadows. Once you get to that, and then just like have fun and very carefully, you know, to push your mid-tone into the light, and then, you know, play with that gradations, you know, explain the playing, explain the light source, you know, make sure to be clear out the shadow shape and shadow edges. Okay, good.